Everyone, my name is Nora, and I'm going to take you through another interesting atomic talk about artificial intelligence and machine learning in test automation. And are you ready? I will be trying to cover a few of the critical questions, particularly around how AI is affecting software testing and test automation. So let's get started. So let's try to understand first what is basically the artificial intelligence is all about. Artificial intelligence is nothing but the intelligence demonstrated by machines as against the human intelligence. Then it has its own subset, which we basically call machine learning, where we do a study of computer algorithms, we use data, and we try to improvise automatically through the experience and by some of the algorithms. We use different kind of approaches here, like supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning, and things like that. There comes another subset of machine learning, which we call deep learning, which is in broader terminology, a study around the artificial neural networks, and then how we can use representation learning out of it. So that's about overall what artificial intelligence is all about. Now, what happens particularly in terms of this domain is like we collect a lot of data, we clean up the data, we improvise on the data, we do a lot of statistics to be able to understand what are the key features, functionalities useful for us. And then we use a lot of machine learning algorithms to be able to arrive for a particular confidence level or maybe a clustering, depending upon the context. And then we start to optimize from there and try to do a continuous learning. So that's about artificial intelligence. Now, having said that, what is artificial intelligence? Let's try to understand why we need AI in test automation. Now, to answer this particular question, I think we can go back to some of the critical challenges around current test automation and then see how we need this kind of AI in test automation. So first and foremost challenge is the skill set. We all understand that automation skill set is an area which we need for a particular domain. And then even if we have something ready in terms of automation skill set, it might be as a human, we might miss some of the automation best practices. Then the maintenance, when we talk about automation, particularly one of the critical example could be where the locators are changing after the releases, and then automation tester has to go back and do update the locators, and that kind of efforts in the maintenance is kind of a challenging area. Then we talk about scaling the automation. Yes, nowadays automation has evolved a lot, and we can say that it is trying to match the speed of the releases, but still there are a lot of scope in terms of automation, and then a lot of efforts can be reduced if you talk about scaling the automation. Now, test data, we need a particular test data or environment to be able to start early and do a kind of automation which is missing. AI comes as a rescue hand in terms of mimicking, creating a test data and environment for us to be able to start early and to be able to improvise the automation testing. And then comes the testing. One of the particular area is a test coverage where might be some of the critical flows which are actually interested for actual end users are getting missed, and the artificial intelligence, the things like pattern recognition and things like that can help us to create this kind of autonomous testing to be able to create the scenarios which might are getting missed in our actual testing. So now let's go back to another question. What are some of the areas where AI in software testing is already happening? One of the particular example is self-filling of the test automation, where we can use artificial intelligence, machine learning to be able to self-fill our automated test cases, self-fill our locator strategies, and then be able to learn and then proactively fix the script for us. AI-based API automation testing, where we can use again the pattern recognition to be able to understand the complexity between the APIs and be able to understand the correlation and create the use cases for us. We discuss about test data generation by mimicking the production-like data by using artificial intelligence for our automation testing. a beautiful technology of spidering, which can be used to create automatically the test cases for us. V-user testing is one of the area where a lot of artificial intelligence, computer visions, things are coming up, which are helping us to identify the defects which maybe the human eyes are not able to detect, and also do on top of functional testing, a lot of different verification and validation checks. Autonomous testing, as we discussed, we can use production data to be able to understand some of the patterns, and then if the patterns are repetitive and useful, then might be we can create those kind of flows from for actual end user, which is like which is going to help us in covering the test coverage in terms of quality test assurance. And then defect analysis and prevention, again by using the statistic analytics, we can understand what are the key areas where might be we can get a defect, and then be able to do proactively some kind of preventive measures for software testing. And then a smart automation suite selection, where by again the trends and the analytics, we can understand which are the particular areas where we should focus more energy in terms of test automation. We should do more automation testing, and we should prioritize the things. So these are some of the areas, and there are a lot many, but these are some of the areas where artificial intelligence is coming in the software testing and automation, and changing the way we used to do the traditional software testing. Now, how will the future look like when we have artificial intelligence in place? To answer this particular question, artificial intelligence will touch every aspect of software development and not just software testing. So it is everywhere around us. It is everywhere around our products. Artificial intelligence will help us on the speed, quality, and the efficiency. So this is for us to be able to focus more in our maybe the interest, or maybe the creative thinking, or maybe the way we are good to deliver something. So it is here to give us that time, and then be able to come as a helping hand for all of us. And as we all understand what artificial intelligence is, so basically it is a good change. And we all understand that if it is for a good, then let's embrace the change and learn from it and try to do a better quality assurance. Thank you very much.